In this video, we introduced the idea of electric potential energy and the electric potential energy between two point charges. And then we're going to follow up with a quick example using electric potential energy and energy conservation. So what we're looking at in this picture, in the first case, I have two like charges that are close to each other. And I hope you agree that these like charges have potential energy, because if I release them from rest, they would spring apart and suddenly I would see kinetic energy. So if I look at a graph of the potential energy between these charges as a function of their separation distance, this is what it looks like. It's actually a section of a hyperbola. And we're using the convention that if these charges are very, very far apart, we should say the potential energy is zero. So that's why I see it leveling off asymptotically to zero as r becomes large. And then as the charges get closer and closer together, the potential energy becomes very large and positive. This makes it so that if you release them from rest at some small value of r, when they spring apart, they're going in the direction of decreasing potential energy as the separation distance becomes large. That potential energy is going down. So everything I just said about these two positive charges is also true for two negative charges, because they repel each other as well. If you try to squish two negative charges really close together, the potential energy becomes large and positive. If you then release them, the system will evolve in the direction of decreasing potential energy, and those negative charges will spring apart. Now, in our second picture, I have unlike charges which are attracted to each other. Again, we're adopting the convention that if these things are very, very far apart, we should say the potential energy is zero. But we know as they get closer and closer together, the potential energy is going down. Because if we release them from rest at some distance, they'll just spontaneously move towards each other. And the direction that they spontaneously move is the direction of decreasing potential energy. So in this case, the potential energy actually becomes negative as r becomes smaller. And maybe one last thing I should say here is if I release these from rest at a separation distance of r, the system will naturally evolve in the direction of decreasing potential energy. And I'll see the potential energy drop and drop and drop. And as that happens, the kinetic energy goes up and up and up. And I see the speed of each charge increasing as they head toward each other. So how do we quantify the potential energy between two point charges? As it turns out, the potential energy as a function of r is given by k, q1, q2, over r. So be careful that r is not squared like it was in Coulomb's law. So in any case that you're studying, the k, the q1, and the q2 are all constants. And then I have this 1 over r to give me the potential energy as a function of r. If I have like charges, then all these constants in the numerator come out to a positive number, and I end up with an upright hyperbola, just like this first graph that I showed. If we have unlike charges, then I end up with a minus sign, and it gives me an upside down section of a hyperbola, like in the second graph that I showed. So let's look at an application of electrical potential energy. So in this problem, I'm shooting two protons at each other, and they have a perfect head-on collision. That's not going to happen very often, but maybe occasionally it happens nearly perfectly. So these protons are shot at each other with high speed, and they end up coming very, very close before they spring away from each other. So they never actually touch because of the repulsive electrical force. And they end up coming to rest with a separation distance of 1 femtometer, which is 10 to the negative 15 meters. And then they spring directly away from each other again. So the idea of the problem is, let's find the electrical potential energy when they were really close together, and then use energy conservation to figure out how fast they're moving once they're really far apart and the potential energy is practically zero. Plugging into our new formula, I put in the Coulomb's law constant, 8.99 times 10 to the ninth, Newton meters squared per Coulomb squared. And then I have two copies of the same charge, so I might as well just write it once and put an exponent on it. So that's 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 Coulombs, that's the elementary charge, and I'm going to square that. And then my closest approach when their speed became zero was 1 femtometer, which is 10 to the negative 15 meters. When I run the numbers on this, I get 2.30 times 10 to the negative 13. And it should come out in joules. But why don't we take a second to study the units just to verify that that's true. So if I examine my units, I had Newton meters squared per Coulomb squared times Coulombs squared, all divided by meters. So this Coulomb squared cancel. One factor of meters cancels, and I end up with Newton meters. And if you recall from the definition of work, a Newton meter is indeed a joule. All right, so let's compute the speed of each proton after they've run off to a great distance. Again, the approximation we're making is that the potential energy at a quote-unquote great distance is approximately zero. So just the energy conservation concept here is that all this potential energy gets converted into the kinetic energy of both of these moving protons. By symmetry, I can say that they both have the same speed. So half of the energy goes into each one. So first I'm going to take half the total potential energy that I started with, and that gives me 1.15 times 10 to the negative 13 joules. So that's the kinetic energy of one of these protons. And then I'm going to relate that to the speed by saying K is 1/2 mv squared for one of these protons. And I'll go ahead and solve for v, multiply by 2, divide by m, and square root the result. I get square root of 2k over m. And we'll go ahead and plug in. And I've got to look up the proton mass here. This is something that you just start to remember when you do enough electrostatics problems. 1.67 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. And my speed comes out to 1.17 times 10 to the 7 meters per second. Again, we already split the kinetic energy in half so that each proton got the same amount. And each one is going this fast. Now you might complain that we should think about special relativity here because this speed is starting to be an appreciable fraction of the speed of light. It's actually about 4% the speed of light. So relativistic corrections might be appropriate here, but this was intended to be a first approximation, just treating the problem classically. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.